The search for Sita. Shri Ram was upset when he saw the ashram deserted. He frantically searched for Sita. Shri Ram looked everywhere. He asked the trees and creepers. He was shocked at Sita's disappearance. Although Lakshman was guarding Sita, she was abducted. If Sita had not been tempted by that golden deer, then Shri Ram and Lakshman continued their search for Sita. On the way, they saw the wounded Jatayu. "Who is responsible for this condition of yours?" "I tried to stop Ravan when he was fleeing with Sita. I tried my best to rescue Sita, but the evil Rakshas cut off my wings and left me mortally wounded. Though I tried my best, I was defeated and the wicked Rakshas flew away with Sita. Shri Ram, I was waiting for you. I have only one last wish. Let me rest my head on your lap so that I shall have a peaceful death." As per Jatayu's wish, Ram let Jatayu rest his head on his lap. Jatayu breathed his last. Then they continued their journey. A terrible Rakshas called Kabandha blocked their way. He had a huge body and a very fearful face. Though Shri Ram and Lakshman were in deep sorrow, they were quite alert. In a flash, they cut off both the hands of Kabandha. The next instant, a handsome man with a luminous face and strong body appeared before them. He was a Gandharva. He said to Shri Ram, "Oh Shri Ram, I am very grateful to you. I have a humble suggestion to help you in your search for Sita. Proceed towards Lake Pampa, which is in the south, close to the Vanar kingdom of Kishkindha. There you will meet a noble Vanar called Sugriv. Your mutual friendship with him will be of valuable help to both of you." Shri Ram and Lakshman reached Lake Pampa. The place was very beautiful. There was ashram of Rishi Matanga. As they neared the ashram, an old lady came out of her hut. She was a Bhil devotee of Shri Ram. She took them in her hut. She was Shabri. Shabri offered berries to Shri Ram. To be sure that each one was sweet, she first tasted them herself and then offered them to Shri Ram. It was done with a noble desire to offer only sweet foods to Ram. Later, Shri Ram and Lakshman proceeded towards Rishyamukh mountain. Sugriv stayed there out of fear of his brother Vali. Vali was bent on killing Sugriv. He had abducted Sugriv's wife Ruma and held her captive. Matang Rishi had cursed Vali that if he set foot upon Rishyamukh, he would die. Vali would not step on that mountain for this reason. Therefore, to save himself from Vali, Sugriv had taken shelter on this mountain. Shri Ram and Lakshman began climbing up the mountain. Sugriv feared that they might be his enemies in an illusionary human form. To find out their identity, he sent Hanuman disguised as a Brahmin. As Shri Ram and Lakshman came near, Hanuman saluted them and asked them, "Who are you, noble beings? Where are you going? You look like mighty warriors." Lakshman answered, "We are King Dashrath's son. This is my elder brother Shri Ram. It was our stepmother who banished us to the forest. During our stay at Panchvati, the evil Rakshas Ravan abducted his sister-in-law Sita. We have vowed to free her from his clutches. We are told that Sugriv might help us in the mission. Therefore, we wish to meet and be friends with him." Hanuman was overjoyed on hearing this. He revealed his true identity and said, "I am Hanuman, a humble servant of Sugriv. Please come with me. I shall take you to Sugriv. Children, remember, one should not hesitate to sacrifice even one's life to help good and virtuous people." One must always respect selfless love.